This is continuing on with step one of Seven Steps to Heaven. In the earlier video, I just talked about memorizing the melody. The next sentence mentions, listen to a wide variety of recordings of the song. And again, I'm using All the Things You Are as our example here. And there are many hundreds, probably thousands, of versions of this particular tune, very popular tune by jazz musicians. The one that I'm going to use here is from a Paul Desmond Jerry Mulligan recording. And I think they actually do a little bit better job of really demonstrating the melody. It's an album called Two of a Mind. And they're going to demonstrate a couple other aspects to learning these songs that I'm going to point out to you a little bit here. We'll listen first to the recording of Paul Desmond, Jerry Mulligan. And they're really going to boil the tune down to its very bare essentials, which is something I'll talk about in a minute here. And so they're really playing the melody in a very stripped down kind of way, and this is an interesting way of looking at most standard tunes, All the Things You Are, On Green Dolphin Street, Autumn Leaves, almost any of the Summertime, any of the Great American Songbook tunes you want to take. The tune All the Things You Are actually has a very interesting kind of structure to it, skeletal type of structure, and that's what you'd want to do as you're investigating these tunes too. Break them down to what are the what some educators refer to as goal notes or target tones, and that's what they've done in this Paul Desmond Jerry Mulligan recording, is really broken it down to just those pivotal notes that kind of create a connect the dots type of thing with the tune. It's actually the third of each of the chords if you're looking at your chord sheet. And then those intervals between each of them happen to be fourths too, so there's this interesting little substructure. Which continues on the next eight bars. As you get to the bridge, it gets away from that kind of fourth building type of thing, and they're not using exclusively just thirds, but you do get, which they play the bridge in a more traditional way on that particular Paul Desmond Jerry Mulligan recording, but the original melody is, and with most tunes you'll find that those kind of arpeggios and the little quarter note things, there are notes that can kind of be stripped away. You can kind of cut away the fat and get to the meat of the tune. In the bridge, it's really, it's a descending pattern. And then a way of using these recordings, this is a particularly good one because they're really outlining that melody and that very skeletal structure. And I actually usually encourage students more to do this type of playing with recordings instead of the play-alongs. Now, there are play-along tracks available at learnjazzstandards.com. And you can, with just the piano, bass, and drum, so it's kind of like a jazz karaoke or something. But I actually, when I do practice with recordings, it's usually traditional recordings like this, not actual play-along recordings. So you could, again, play through this. Thank you. is it? With something I was mentioning in the earlier clip, when you're memorizing the melody, if you're playing along with that recording, it's just sort of like playing with metronome, a little bit more interesting than playing along with metronome. But the first time through, I just played the melody as they were doing that kind of outlined, pointillistic kind of version. And then as Paul Desmond went into his improvisation, I went to just playing only those target notes or those goal notes all the way through there. So you're really getting the tune kind of subconsciously, and getting away from the sheet as soon as possible is very important, so that you're really memorizing the tune and you've got it, under your fingers, and you've got it in your head, that form all the way through, and you can start improvising along with them. I think also improvising along with those type of recordings, you're also being able to pick up ideas that they're playing. As you're playing the melody, you're kind of seeing how their improvisations are weaving around those target notes and those main parts of the tune. And really, basically, all of these tunes can be approached that way, where you can kind of strip them down. That's part of the investigative process, really figure out what makes the tune tick. What is its skeletal structure? So as you start to play through it, you're still keeping those as your kind of lifeline. I'm always landing. I ended up landing on those notes from the melody. Thing to really keep that tune in mind and not to abandon or jettison the tune too soon. I think that happens a lot of times. It's like, well, good, we got the melody out of the way, now I can get into the interesting stuff, the improvisations, where ironically it's usually, for most listeners, it's really the melody is the interesting thing. And the thematic idea of really keeping that threading, Sonny Rollins and Thelonious Monk and Miles Davis, excellent examples of kind of thematic, lyrical improvisers that you can still hear the melody throughout their improvisations. And Monk would even refer back to it in the middle of an improvisation in a lot of his recordings. So that's really that second sentence in step one. It's listening to the wide variety of recordings. I've just taken one here, the Paul Desmond, Jerry Mulligan one, and showing you some ways that you can kind of practice along with that to help strengthen your feeling of form, and also to kind of investigate how the tune is put together.